Hi, it's Vicky here and welcome to another art journal layout. Today I am going to be making a bright and happy summer themed layout. So first of all, I am going to start out by stamping this hibiscus flower stamp all over my pages. I am using Versamark ink and I plan to white emboss all these flowers so I can create a nice pattern for my background. The little flower comes from a Paper Smooches stamp set and I believe it's called Get Out of Town, and I will make sure to link everything below the video in the details area and also on my blog. So now I'm using my embossing powder, and this embossing powder is vanilla white and it's by WOW. So I am going to apply it in both pages and then use my heat gun to set the powder on my page. And this is the result. You probably can't see much at the moment, but once I apply my color all over, you will be able to see all the little flowers that are stamped there. So today I will be using my distress inks to color everything, and I am applying a couple of colors on my page using my blending tools. The colors I am using today are Broken China and Spiced Marmalade. The embossing powder actually resists the distressing, so you can see the little flower stamped there. And my little helper Ginger is on my craft desk, so I just saved him from stepping all over my distressings. And now he is trying to drink water from my jar with brushes, so I have to save him from that as well. And finally, he's going to sit just next to me and watch how I do my art journaling and check out if I'm doing everything correctly. So as you can see, I am meeting both these colors at the center of the page where I can blend them nicely, and I will be doing the exact same thing on the other page as well. This is the final result, and what I love about using distress inks is that I can do a lot of techniques with water. So I'm spraying a lot of water all over the pages, and I hope you can see how wet my page is. And after leaving it for a few seconds, I'm going to dab off all the water, and this will create some nice splashes and an interesting background for my layout. Distress inks react with water, and just because I want to seal them down, I am using Distress Micro Glaze. This is a new product by Tim Holtz that really seals down all your distress ink. After micro glaze, I am going to cover up my layout with matte medium. I am doing that because I will be using my big brush markers later on to do all the shading, and they work great on over matte medium. And here is Ginger making sure that I cover up all the page with gel medium. I am going to leave my page aside to dry, and I will work on a scrap piece of paper that I have folded in half. So with my pencil, I am going to draw a watermelon slice. Then I am going to use my scissors and cut all the little parts. And just because I want to have a nice and vibrant layout today, I will be using these three colors by Dilusions. These are Dilusions paints, and I really, really love these colors. And if you are into art journaling, you will love them also. They are nice, easy to apply with a blending tool. You will see how smooth they go. And a little goes a long way when it comes to this paint, just because it's not thick, it's nice and liquid, and you can apply it with any sponge that you have or with your brushes. So you will find that these really dry quickly, and that's great when you don't want to wait for things to dry and you want to move quickly on your layout. As well as what I really love about it is that they are semi-opaque, so it will not cover up layers that you have below on your art journal. But at the same time, you can build up the color with more layers and make it opaque if you like. So. And I really think that these three colors are the perfect colors for my watermelon today. And now that my watermelon is ready, I am going to do some stenciling. So I'm using this Rage stencil by Tim Holtz, and I will apply embossing paste. I am also making sure that I won't apply embossing paste at the fold of my book. So as you can see, I have placed my stencil smartly, so I do have a gap where the folding is. As I remove my stencil, you will see that I do have a rectangle formed by the stencil, and just because I want to have my shape a little bit more organic and random, I am going to use my spatula, my finger or my baby wipe, and make sure that this is not as rectangular as it looks at the moment. This is a stamp set by Simon Says Stamp with falling backgrounds. It has dots, hearts, and even droplets. So I am going to use parts of this background stamp with the droplets, and I am going to stamp the seeds for my watermelon. I am using archival ink for this. And as you can see, I mask off some droplets here and there, and I will go ahead and stamp all the seeds. And now that the seeds are there, I am using a punch to cut out a circle as if I have someone bite from this watermelon, but I don't really like how it looks at the moment, so I am going to grab another punch, and I think that looks better now. So now that I'm happy with this, I am going to use my gel medium and stick the watermelon on my page. Once gel medium is nice and dry, I can then use my big brush markers to do the shading as I usually do. If you are new to this technique, this is pretty much easy. You just grab a marker that is slightly darker than your background. You go all around the shape and add a little bit of ink with your marker and then smudge it with your finger. You always need to make sure that you are working on a non-porous surface, and that's why I have covered up previously everything with gel medium. Also, you need to make sure that gel medium is nice and dry before you go ahead and use your markers, because gel medium is actually a glue, and if the tip of your marker touches gel medium, it will ruin your markers. When I finish with shading, I always use a black thin marker and go all around the shape. This helps the shape to pop up against the background. And finally, I always use my white gel pen to add some highlights. I have used my pencil to draw a cocktail glass and I am going to cut it out with my scissors. If you don't feel confident about your drawing skills, then you can always print out a shape from the internet. So now I am going to add my cocktail inside the glass, and to do so I'm using my distress inks. So I am using mustard seed and abandoned coral, and I am going to blend both colors inside my glass so I can make a nice and refreshing cocktail. I get a lot of questions about my finger dabbers as well as the storage box that I have, and you can find links to both these on my description area and on my blog. They are both by Tsukineko. And now that my cocktail glass is ready, I am going to create a lime slice. So I have punched out a circle which I have colored yellow, and now with my finger dabber I am going to add some green at the edges. Once this is done, I will be using my white gel pen and add the details inside the lime later on. These are a couple of paper straws which I am going to cut in size and flatten them, so I can stick them on my layout as if they are coming out of the glass. I have used gel medium and stuck down the glass along with all its accessories. So now I'm using my white gel pen to add a little bit more highlights on my layout. And my layout is pretty much finished. All that's left to do now is to add the quote. And for my quote, I will be using stickers today instead of stamping letter by letter. And that's because I have some nice embossed flowers on my background, and that will not allow me to stamp my letters nicely there. So I'm using these letters by Kelly Purkey. These are sticker letters, and I have the same in different colors. And that's why I have used many of them. So I've used three different colors of stickers, and also with my white gel pen I am going to add some highlights to help those letters pop against the background. And that was the layout for today. I hope you had fun and got inspired. And if you did, don't forget to leave me a comment as well as give me thumbs up on my YouTube channel. Here are a few close-up photos of my art journal layout today. If you haven't subscribed to my channel already, make sure to do so, because this is the way to tell me that you love my projects and you want to see more. For more inspiration, you can click on the image and watch another summer-themed layout. If you are watching from a mobile device, I'll make sure to add the link to this art journal just below in the description area. Thank you all for watching!